what is the information of the security that being exchanged in this case? NAS, this is a non-access stratum. That means we already... But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head, under my bed. Hello, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. In this video, I'm going to share it to you how we can do some sniffing from the Android phone that already using the Qualcomm chips. In this case, is Snapdragon. I'm using the Redmi Note 5 or 7. I forgot. I think it's Redmi Note 7 in this case. And it's already rooted. This is the must condition prerequisite. You need to have Qualcomm chips Android mobile phone that already rooted. And the rest is you need to have the ADB. If you want to know how we set up the phone with the ADB, you need to watch my old video about the Pegasus spyware for the Android. I explain it to you how we connect ADB in this case. But don't worry, I will just going to spill it to you, but maybe not everything. But for the complete for the ADB connectivity, you need to watch that one. And in this video, the benefit of this script compared with the others is, which is that the other doesn't have, but this one have, is you can sniffing the TDD channel, right? Because the time domain in this case is quite challenging to get this one, right? If you are using the ordinary LTE sniffer, but in this one you can get it, example in this case. And the good thing, this is not about LTE only. Others radio technologies such as 3G, 2G, it's even can capture with this one. That is the good news about this one, guys. How we can do it? The first thing is we need to connect our phones first using the ADB, right? So the complete one you can check in my Pegasus spyware video. I'm going to put the link here, and I will just going to spill this a little bit in the surface. So the first thing is we just need to TCP. We need to set up, for example, the port is 5555 in this case, right? Okay, so it's already restarted basically. And then after that, I'm going to list the ADB devices. ADB devices. Okay, this one. Then I just do some ADB connect this one. Okay, already connected. Okay, right guys? And the next thing is you need to go to this GitHub. This is the GitHub. Thanks and the credit to the P1 security, that the one that have this repository in this case. The first thing is we need to install some prerequisite. I'm going just help you to make it very easy in this case. So we just need to install this one. But I'm going to suggest this to you. We just need to install this in the very safe or in the very secure environment, right guys? So do not ever install this the library directly to your own core of your own essential Python, which is bring by your own operating system itself. So I'm going to isolate this library. In this case, the name is QC Super. We just do this one, right guys? So this Python 3, we will create the special environment for this one. So I'm going just using the name, the My QC Super in this case. So I'm just going to this one. Okay, it's already created. Then what I'm gonna do, I'm going to go to inside of this one, and after that I'm going to activate first. This is the very thing that you need to do first. Okay, already activate. Now we are good to go to install this one, guys. We will not running the apt install because you know I'm using MacBook, so we will just dump the pickup file and then we can see it later. Okay, so I'm going to running this. Okay, don't worry guys, this is already good because we are already running. You can see here my QC Super, that means we already running this in this environment. You should consider upgrade this pip 3 install. Okay, I'm going to upgrade this, no worries. So because this is using pip install, I'm just going to this pip 3 because I'm using Python 3, and then I'm just going to install this. I'm just going to upgrade this one, no worries. Okay, great, excellent. The next is, after we already running this, we need to git clone this one, right? I using this one, usually I just using this command, git clone this. And then I will just going to using the this one. Okay, we already git clone this, so we just need to running this one, guys. Copy this. Excellent. So the upgrade, etc., is already run in this case, right, guys? This is very good. Great. Excellent. Pi serial, Pi crate. I think there are some of them is Pi, like, for example, if I'm not wrong, the Pi crate is created this library by the P1 security company itself. Okay, this is done already. That is the steps that how we can install this. Well, not really install it, to set up the environment itself. Okay, next, we are going to go to the next one. But guys, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this to others. And don't forget to switch on the bell. If I have something that I new uploaded, it will be notified to you guys. And as of this video is recorded, this channel still in the growing phase. Still not able to monetize this one. So, but if you want to help me, for example, to upgrade the accessories, to have a better voice, to have a better facility, and of course it will be motivate me, don't forget to donate in the coffee link in the description of the link that I'm going to put it here also in the descriptions. And also I told you about the Pegasus spyware link, right guys? If you want to see how to do some ADB connectivity, I already put it also in this link, also in this descriptions, guys. Okay, once the installation is already finished, then we are good to go to observe to running this the magic script from that actually is utilizing the Qualcomm chips in this case. So what will be the look like? What will be the result of this one? So what we're gonna do, we go back again to the GitHub and we will see which one that we're gonna play for the script itself, right? Okay, I'm going to using this one because I'm going to running this in my MacBook. And if you're gonna running this, I think this is will not be work if you're running this in MacBook. It will be work if you're running this in the Ubuntu. So we're gonna choose this one, of course. Okay, then I will go to here. So QC super --adb pickup Adam, and this is the file name that I'm going to use in this case. So what we're gonna do, we're going to start this. We're just going to running this, and of course because I'm using the sudo. Boom, it's already run, guys. Let's make some test call in this case, right, guys? And what I'm gonna do, I'm going to call this number again. I have another number. Wait. I'm going to call my other number with this. Okay. Testing 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, great. Let's drop this call and we will observe what will be the look like in the Wireshark, right? I'm so excited. So this one is okay. Okay guys, this is the file itself, the my pickup. The pickup is exact the same with the comment that I already run here. So I'm going to open this. Okay, this is the file itself. Let's check, guys, what will be look like. Okay, you can see here there's a RSS request and then there's a setup, of course, in this case. We can see it from here. For example, this is the setup. I will just expand everything here. Okay, this is the setup, the transmission, etc. Of course, there are no any sensitive informations here, of course. And the most and there's some service request also here for to make a call in this case. There's some service request here as well, and this is the service request. Okay, and of course this is cannot be decoded, and this is the most exciting things, guys. We can see what kind of the shifring algorithm that for secure this one. In this case they are using EEA2 and Integrity Pro algorithm is EIA2 in this case. So we can see what is the information of the security that being exchanged in this case. Okay, of course the configuration is connected, etc. And the most I will jump to this one. This is very interesting also, guys. This is there is some NAS. This is a non-access stratum. That means we already found there is a, in the downlink itself, they put also information from the packet core. From the core network, because EMM, which is actually from the core network in this case, right, guys? Well, actually it's MME, right? Why don't you put your comment here? Okay, etc. Okay, guys, what do you think, guys? this is the solutions for you. For example, if you want to LTE sniffing, but you need to know what it will be the dialog protocol in your phone, for example, in the TDD band. Because my other previous video for the LTE sniffer, they cannot caters for the TDD. It's only FDD in this case. But of course, because this one, of course, has some limitations, this is already sniffing what will be the traffic that bound to our own SIM card. Unlike the LTE sniffer, can sniff everything around this air in this case, but only the FDD. Okay, as always, same in other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.